Hey everybody, it's me, and I'm just coming in to do a real quick video today with an update really about my locks and my hair and how it's been doing since I decided to semi-freeform and kind of let my hair do its own thing. Now, what that means to me with the semi-freeforming, I am not doing as much manipulation. I am, I used to palm roll at least twice a month. And when I palm rolled, I do all my hair, all my locks. And it would take well over an hour, sometimes two, to do a whole head. And I noticed that here I am, here in my eighth year of locking, that my roots were getting thin. And I knew it was because I was twisting too much over and manipulating. But I continued to do it anyway because I wanted my hair to look neat most of the time. And what I ended up doing was losing a couple of locks in the front of my head. After thinning out so much, I had lost two of my locks right here. So I had to go in and kind of restart them. And I decided that while I was retraining my new locks, I would just make a, resolve to just kind of, back up off of twisting so much and just let my hair form naturally and just kind of neaten it up, make sure my, none were merging together or anything. So that's what I've been doing. And I'm going to just show you a little bit of how my locks are doing, how they're coming in. Now, you're going to see some gray because I've got some gray hair in there. But these locks are coming in very nicely. I did a cold wash this morning. And so these are the only ones that I really twist. I don't think I even used any product on these. I just used the leave-in conditioner, almond oil, and, what else did I use? Yeah, just a leave-in conditioner. And I just, got these new ones coming in here, real nice. I have one up here also that is coming in, a baby that's coming in. And just kind of show you a little bit closer on my locks, how my hair is looking since I don't or haven't been manipulating it. You can see kind of, and I don't know if you can see this good, but my locks, here's one that's merged together that I had merged. That is, this is actually locked together now. See, it's hard to position in this camera to make sure you see it. But this is one that was thin at the roots that's actually merged with this thicker lock right here now. So it's actually two. The rest of my hair, all the way around, you'll see where, I've got some new ones coming in that I'm just training. And so I'm twisting those, but all the other locks are just doing okay. They're doing great. I don't know. My roots are definitely thicker. I noticed that a lot. My roots are thicker in my hair. I'll just show you the front because I can't see if I'm in the right frame to show you how they really look. But if I can bring this in a little bit. The roots of my hair have thickened up a lot. Sun is interfering with this, but for the most part, I have gone through my locks and clipped the ends of some locks that were kind of raggedy on the end. They were thin, like in the middle of my lock. These two I actually did, and I'm not even concerned that my locks are uneven. It's really not a concern to me. Length of my locks. What I'm doing, and I used to do this when I didn't have locks, it's good to go through and clip the end of your hair every now and then because the end of your hair need to be clipped because it's dead hair on the end. And mostly, with locks being matted together, I probably have a lot of dead hair in there. So I've gone through and I'm still in the process of doing this, but Some of the ends that were, you know, really thin, like dead on the end, thin locks that were, you know, part way thick, and then there's a thinness in the middle. I'm just clipping right at the end of that. I'm trying to see if I can find one now, because I clipped like three today. This was one that was longer, but I just clipped the end off, you know, clipped it off so I can, you know, just let them grow in thick, you know, during this period. You know, kind of reconditioning, training my hair. These, again, this is a new one that's coming in, but this used to be so short, and it's coming in real good now. Coming in real good. That was a short little baby lock. It's coming in. I've got some that are back here. Let's see. I don't know how this camera's working. This is a new camera, y'all. Babies back here that are coming in. All in the back, the nape of my neck. They're coming in. So I have a lot of new growth. A lot of locks that are actually coming in. And I'm feeling them in. Just let them do what they're doing. You know, I've decided that I wouldn't be so vain about my hair and the look and just let it do what it's going to do. So I wanted to just kind of show you an update of what I'm doing, what's working for me in this season with my locks. I did a co-wash earlier. I think I told you that. I'm not sure if I told you that. I just co-washed it with a conditioner, you know, that I like. I think I used Frutis, the antifreeze. And I'm just letting my hair air dry. And, you know, what's going to happen is as I finish, you know, as it finishes to dry, as it dries completely, I'm just going to go through and, you know, spritz some oil in it. Making sure to get the ends. I think some time with our locks, because we're locked, we just kind of forget the ends of the hair. And, you know, the ends need to be treated too. The ends of the hair. See how mine look down here? You know, I've got long, I've got short, you know, it's all blended in. I've been considering evening that up a little bit, but I'm just going to let it do what it do. Those that are split, I'm clipping those ends off, you know. My mama used to tell me, clip the dead hair. So I am definitely clipping off the dead hair. And I don't know if some styles are going to be affected the way I wear my hair. I'm not sure. But I'm just doing it anyway. I know I'm wearing a lot more scarves lately. Because the front of my hair is a little challenged right here. Because the new ones are growing in. So sometimes it looks a little weird there. When they're sticking up and trying to grow. But I'm just wearing scarves now to kind of train it until it comes in. And, you know, I can see where the free forming is definitely thickening up my hair. I tried to show you all in the scalp. And because I'm not too good at keeping myself in the frame of the camera, I don't know if you really got to see it. But definitely my roots are thickening up. I am only twisting the ones that are new, the ones that are still trying to be trained, like these in the front. This one here, this is trained. This is locked right now. That's a lock. The ones that are in the back of my head at the nape, and I'll try to show you again, but these that are in the back, I'm doing those. I am twisting these. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. About 5 or 6 baby locks are coming in. I need a line, but that's about it. I'm going to let them come in, let them just do what they're doing. And in the meantime, while my new ones are coming in and being trained, I'm, again, just wearing pretty scarves on my head. You know, braid outs every now and then. And just kind of letting it do what it does. But I did want to just come in and do a video for you all who our lockers and let you see what hair looks like that's, you know, kind of free formed when you have lost your locks or lost a couple locks and you just need to, you know, kind of retrain it again. That was my suggestion. Just keep your hands out of it and just kind of let it come in, because it will come in. You will grow the lock back, but just trying to avoid the over twisting that actually leads to the breakage is what I'm doing right now. So it's coming in great. My hair is sticking it up, and I'm actually clipping the ends to the dead end. So for the new year, going into it with a whole new thing, you know, I'm not cutting, but I am just clipping the ends. So long enough. Okay, y'all, take care. Bye-bye.